Hey guys, welcome to ElectroFun. This is my 14th video tutorial on Python programming. In my previous video tutorial, I have started with loops, Python loops, and I have explained while loop with a practical example. In this video tutorial, we are going to study on for loop. It is the same as while loop. It is used to execute multiple statements. So let's get started. Idle. Before executing the statements, it checks for the sequence and then the statements are executed. Let's see what is the difference between while and for, and the difference in syntax as well as the way of representing. So let's say I'm taking a list having random values. Okay. And then I define for index in I, which basically means index in I, which is from 0 to n minus 1, and print index. Okay, so as you can see, there's a iterating expression and this is a sequence. So this basically means index, or you can say range, from where you have the starting point, and this basically means the complete sequence which you want to access. So here from index from 0 to I, which is n minus 1, it will print the index, which gives me the value of list as shown. So you can check for like a letter in ElectroFun. Oh, I forgot the colon, so I'll just copy paste it again. The colon and print the letter. So let's see what we get. Enter. So we are getting each alphabet sequentially. So it is executing it until the last character of a string. So this is about for loop. Let's take a practical example of for loop and see how it works. So let's say I have a list of values and I need to square it using for loop. So squaring the values. So let's say I have I 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then let's start with for index in I, print. We need a square of every term in I. So there's an exponential function which we can directly use, which is this, and we are done. So let's save it. Desktop, name it for loop, and let's run the module. Let's see what we get. Okay, so what we are getting is we have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and we are getting square of each of the values. Now let's study the code. What I have done is I have just taken a list of the various values, and then I have assigned index, which means it will start from 0, or you can say the starting value of any of the string or list or tuple, and then it will end to the last value. And then what I have done is that value to the exponent 2. So 1 exponent 2, which will give me 1, 2 exponent 2, which will give me 4, and this way the loop will be executed till the last value. There is other way of doing the same thing. What I'll do is, instead of taking index, I'll take I in range. So what it means is 1, 6. Why I'm taking 1, 6? You say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it works the same way where you are defining a statement or condition which is less than 5 or less than 6. So the number 6 statement will not be executed. Now here we have 5 values from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And we need to execute it. So let's see if we take 5 and if we take 4, what we get. Now save it and run it. Yeah, that was an expected error. I did not change over here. Okay. Yeah. So what I'm getting is 1, 4, and 9. So when I'm defining to 4, I'm getting 3 values, which is 1, 2, and 3. So what I'll do is, for defining 5 values, I need to define till 6. So we are done. Yeah. So we are getting the same output as we got for the previous method. So I hope you have understood what is for loop, and I have explained it using a practical example where we are squaring each of the number in the list. So if you have any doubts or you need a detailed explanation, you can visit my blog, which the link will be in the description below. Till then, like my video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.